reading from our epistle text. Do not be deceived, my brothers. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. James, in our text for today, really is a bookend for John chapter 1. In John chapter 1, Jesus is likened, and rightly so, to the light that has come into the world. There was a darkness and shadow over the world because of our sin. Sin does not simply affect one person. It's impossible. When we sin, it affects not only our brothers and sisters, but even the entire world. I don't think that we have to look too far to see that our world is dying. It's definitely not in a state of perfection, the way that it was in the Garden of Eden. It's true that we have been kicked out of that place and that we are now east of Eden. And in east of Eden, we find that we once again were thrust into darkness, begging for light with minds and with lips, but perhaps not with hearts. Here's the reality of the darkness. A robber does not break into a house in the middle of a day. It just doesn't really happen. They wait until nightfall in order to not be seen by anyone. And as they enter into the home over the cloak of darkness, they are able to sin in thievery, perhaps murder, but definitely covetousness. On that same note, we have the fact that we as Christians strive to be in the darkness. Why? Because we believe that we can get away with more if we are in the darkness than if we are in the light. For example, you've heard me say over and over that our sixth commandment, if we all had our sixth commandment sins laid bare for all of us to see one another's lustful thoughts, we would go running screaming from the building. For our sins to be open and laid out in front of everyone, we desire to run to the darkness to hide with the thieves and the murderers and the covetousness of others. We prefer the company of the darkness. At least that is our old Adam. Because again, we prefer darkness. There's a reason why if you walk into a kitchen and you turn on the lights, you find cockroaches scurrying for under the refrigerator, under cabinets, trying to find a way out of the darkness, or out of the light. So it is for humanity. When the light shines upon us, we desire to run and scurry and try to get out of the light and into the darkness, because all of our sins of believing in other gods, acting as if are naked before God. And yet, we are not ashamed. Why? Because Christ, through the Holy Spirit, has laid upon us robes of righteousness. We are no longer cockroaches, but baptized Christians. Says you are caught.